friends, we're coming up on Halloween, and Halloween is one of my very favorite holidays. And so I'd like to share with you some optional art projects you can do to get in the mood for something spooky. Remember, optional means that you do not have to do it. It's just something fun and extra. And it also means I might be using some materials that you don't have at home. But you can always watch and enjoy, and yeah, it's gonna be great. So let's get started. For this project, you're going to need a few things. We're going to be using paint today, which means that I need my paper towels, my paintbrush, a clean cup of water, and I'm also going to need some paint. I have red and blue, white, which you can't really see, and black. That's all I need in my kit for that. I also need a paper to paint on. Now, for the second half of this project, we're going to need a black piece of paper, a white pencil, some scissors, and some glue. Now, this is a very, very large kit, right? So if you are missing something, you can make do, use crayons, whatever you want. Art is all about creativity and problem solving, so I'm excited to see how you make this project your own. But I'm going to get started here. Today we're talking about tint and shade. So tint is where you create a color or a hue and you add white to it. Shade is when you take a hue, your color, and add black to it. We're going to be using both tint and shade in our artwork today. And that element of art is called value. Value. Okay? So let's begin with some color mixing. I'm going to try and create a nice purple, which makes me think that I'm going to need another paper plate to mix more color on. So I went and grabbed that. And let's get to mixing. I'm going to create the color you get when you mix red and blue. Do you know what color you get? Did you say violet? Because you're correct. Remember, you might have said purple and you're still right, but in art we use the word violet. To get violet, you are going to mix red and you want a lot of red. So I'm going to take my paintbrush and really load it up with red to kind of create a little puddle here. Then I'm going to add in a little bit of blue. Not too much. Blue is a very powerful color. Remember, you can always add more, but you can't always take it away. Then we get to mixing. This looks a little red to me. If it looks almost brown, that means that it has too much red. Need to add a little bit more blue. There we go. That looks like a really, really nice violet. It almost looks black on your paper, or on your camera. I'm gonna clean my brush. Trying to keep the hair of my paintbrush looking nice. So we need to take care of our paintbrushes. And let's get going. I'm going to create kind of a spooky sky. Okay? So to do that, I'm going to create a white moon. Okay? So I'm going to dip into my white here. Looks like I'm dipping into nothing because you can't really see it on your camera. And I'm going to put my moon right here. Now, my moon's already getting a little bit flooded with the purple, but that's okay because we're going to come back and do a whole bunch of mixing today to create that value. Now, without cleaning my brush, I'm just going to go straight into my violet and start to swirl. Remember, you don't want to jump all around because you're just going to get kind of a mix. You want to start in and go out. your brush ever gets dry and starts leaving these streaks, it's always okay to wet the brush and go back in for more paint. I'm gonna go and add some more streaks here, trying to get it to spread. Add some more purple. Okay, I'm gonna go in and add more white to the center of my moon, and I'm just going to keep mixing in my white and blend it outward. My goal with this piece is to kind of create a spooky moon and have the light of the moon kind of radiating outwards. So I'm gonna speed up the video and you can kind of watch my process. Let's get started.
Something strange.
Come with us and you will see. This our town of Halloween.
This is Halloween. This is Halloween. Pumpkins scream in the dead of night.
This is Halloween. Everybody make a scene.
Trick or treat.
Tell the neighbors on the diaphragm.
It's our town. Everybody's free.
This town of Halloween.
I am the one hiding under your bed. Teeth ground sharp and eyes glowing red.
I am the one hiding under your stairs. Fingers like snakes and spiders in my hair.
This is Halloween, this is Halloween. Halloween, 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 Halloween.
In this town we call home, everyone hail to the pumpkin song.
Okay, I'm going to pause here because I have finished with my tent. I have created enough white in my tent to kind of radiate outward. And now I want to start adding some shade. So while I'm talking to you, I'm just going to go in and add just a straight circle of white for my moon. Like this. Oh my. And I can see that I have drug a whole thing of white paint just right across. So I think I'm just gonna turn that into a shooting star like that and call it good. In art, there are no mistakes. There's just happy accidents. And that right there, my friends, was a very happy accident. So I'm just layering in some white and I'll probably go back in once everything is dry and just add a complete white circle. But now let's talk about shade. When we add black to our color. So here's my purple. I'm gonna add a little bit more water to it. Add some more red, add some more blue, mix up a new purple batch. That looks beautiful. Now, black, just like blue, is a very powerful color, okay? So I'm going to add just a tiny bit to my palette and blend it into just a corner, just like that. Okay, it's kind of hard for you to see, but I think you'll see better once I start going. Now, just like when I was working on my tent, I started here and moved out to let it get dark. I'm gonna start here at the bottom and move in. So my darkest shade will be here. Okay, and you can already see that. Obviously, I am making an enormous mess. If you know me by now, you know I am a very messy artist. And that's okay, because I clean up my mess. So make sure, artists, that you are cleaning up your mess too. So you can see this very, very dark purple here. I'll probably even make it even darker. Just like this. I really want a very dark, dark color. Now it's time to begin to blend it in, okay? So I'm gonna wet my paintbrush. Because this is a water-based paint, water will re-wet your paint. So if you're ever like, oh my gosh, it's so dry, I don't know how to keep working with it, just remember that when you use watercolor or tempera or something like that, even acrylic, they're water-based, so you can use water to kind of blend it in. Now, I'm going to go back to my regular violet and just kind of work in just my straight violet. No white is added, no black is added, and we call that our pure hue. Just the straight color. Okay? And I think at the very end, at the very bottom of my painting, I'm going to have almost black. Just almost black down here. Just like I had almost white here, I'm going to have almost black down here. Okay? And then probably blend that a bit with some water. My brush is not super loaded with water. Just has just enough to kind of get the paint moving again. Just like that. See, I think even that might have been just a smidge too much. That's all right. We'll make it work. Just kind of blending it in like that. Go back in for some regular old violet, just my straight hue, and work that in. There you go. Okay. I am super, super pleased with how this turned out. What I'm going to do is I am going to pause my video and clean up. And if you're painting along with me, you might want to pause and clean up too, because we're moving on to the next stage. Oh, yep, and there it is. So I need to kind of fix this mess a bit. Pause the video. Okay, my space is all nice and clean. I got all that extra paint off the table. Luckily, it came up super easy, and now it's time to add a spooky house. So I have some black paper, I have some scissors, and a white pencil. What I'm going to do is create, like draw out a house, a haunted house, a spooky house, something. And then I'm going to cut it out with my scissors and glue it onto my finished artwork over there. Once it's all dry, of course. So, let's get started. I'm going to go ahead and speed up the video, and you can just watch and follow along.
This town, don't we love it now? Everybody's waiting for the next surprise.
Found that corner man hiding in the trash can. Something's waiting now to pounce, and how you scream?
This is Halloween!
And slightly green.
Aren't you scared?
Well, that's just fine.
Say it once, say it twice. Take a chance and roll the dice.
Ride with the moon in the dead of night.
Everybody scream. Everybody scream.
Okay, so here is my finished house. If you were watching me while I was drawing, you saw that I started with some basic shapes. Some triangles, some lines, some squares, and I went out from there. You can look online for spooky houses, and that will help you give you some ideas so that you can create your very own spooky silhouette. Now, it's time for me to cut this out. I am going to do my best to try to cut the windows out as well. And we'll see what it looks like when it's all done. I'm very excited. All right, here we go.
I am the wind blowing through your hair.
I am the shadow on the moon at night, filling your dreams to the brim with fright.
This is Halloween, this is Halloween. Halloween, 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 Halloween,
Halloween.
That's our job.
But we're not mean
in our town of Halloween.
In this town,
don't we love it now?
Everyone's waiting for the next surprise.
Skeleton Jack might catch you in the back and
scream like a bat, you make you jump out of your skin.
This is Halloween, everybody scream.
Won't you please make way for a very special guy?
Wildman Jack is king of the pumpkin patch. Everyone hail to the pumpkin king.
Okie dokie. So here is my cut-out house. If you noticed when I was cutting and I had to get to a window, I will fold my paper, make a small cut, unfold it, then stick in my scissors, and that helps a lot. Now, you're probably noticing that there is still a lot of white lines from my pencil. That's okay. When we turn it over, we get this super spooky, perfect silhouette. And now it is time to add it to our value background. So here is my background that I was working on. And here is my super spooky silhouette. Now you're noticing that it doesn't quite fit on the page, and that is okay. You can just leave it the way it is, like this, or you can just cut it off at the edges. It's up to you. But either way, I think this looks amazing, and now it's time to glue it down. So to finish up this project, you're gonna get some glue. You'll put it on the messy side of your silhouette and then press down onto your painted paper, just like this. Now, if you want, you can also use the scraps of paper and cut out things like bats. You could cut out a spooky tree. Make this project your own. I cannot wait to see what you do. You're all so creative and wonderful, and I think it's gonna turn out great no matter what. But that's all that I have for today, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys.